Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to be discussing double integrals over general regions. Let's start with an example. We are going to evaluate the double integral of x plus y over d, where d is the set of ordered pairs such that x is between 0 and 1, and y is between 0 and the square root of x. Solution. So we have our double integral, and then we have the x plus y. And now we need to figure out which one we want to put here. Do we put dy first or do we put dx first? Well, because in the set D, y includes the variable, right? Y is between 0 and the square root of x. We want the variable term on the inner integral. So we're first going to integrate with respect to y. And we're going to go from 0 to the square root of x. So 0 to the square root of x. And then we'll integrate with respect to x. And we'll integrate from 0 to 1. 0 to 1. This is equal to the definite integral from 0 to 1. Now we're going to integrate x plus y with respect to y. So when we do that, we treat all of the x's as constants. And so when we integrate x, we just get xy. When we integrate y, we use the power rule. There's a 1 here as an exponent. So it'll be y squared over 2 because you add 1 to the exponent and divide by 2. Then we have a bracket. I'm going to use a double bracket just for extra clarity. And let's write our limits again. The lower limit is y equals 0. The upper limit is y equals the square root of x. And then we also still have the dx. This is really more of an exercise in notation. It's really important to be careful and write down everything very correctly. Okay, this is equal to the definite integral from 0 to 1. First, we plug in the top function, so y equals square root of x, and that gets plugged into y. That's going to give us x, square root of x, plus, and then plugging in the square root of x into y here will give us the square root of x squared, which is, well, I'll write it as the square root of x squared. We'll simplify it in the next step, over 2. Then we subtract and plug in 0, but then everything's going to be 0 in that case, right? Because y is 0, so we don't have to write it. And then parentheses, and then we have our dx. All right, let's clean this up a little bit. I'm going to do a little bit of work on the side here to save us some time. So we have x times the square root of x. That's really x times x to the 1/2. And so there's a 1 on the exponent on the x. So you can add exponents. That will be 3/2. So this is actually the definite integral from 0 to 1 of parentheses x to the 3/2 plus 1/2. Just pulling out that 2 and writing it as a 1/2. And then when you square the square root of x, you're just going to get x. And then we have our dx. Very nice. Now we're in a more familiar place. This integral is not too difficult. Now we're just going to use the power rule to finish up. Integrating x to the 3/2, we add 1 to the exponent. So 3/2 plus 1 is really 3/2 plus 2/2. So that's 5/2. And when we divide by 5/2, we really multiply by 2/5. Plus 1/2. And here we have a 1. So we get x squared over 2, again using the power rule. And we're going from 0 to 1. This is equal to, we first plug in the 1. So it's going to give us 2/5. 1 to the 5/2 is 1, so it goes away. Plus 1/4, because 1 squared is 1. Minus, and then you plug in the 0, and everything is 0. We end up with 2/5 plus 1/4. And we can do the addition by finding a common denominator. We can multiply the 2/5 by 4 over 4 and the 1/4 by 5 over 5. It's going to give us 8 over 20 plus 5 over 20. And when we add them, we get 13 over 20. So not a very difficult problem, but it does take some time to do, and it's just an exercise in being careful. Let's do this example. Sketch the region of integration and set up integrals for both orders of integration. So we have some function, and we have a double integral over d, and d is the region bounded by y equals the square root of 4 minus x squared and y equals 0. Solution. So to do this problem, we'll start by giving a rough sketch of our function here, y equals the square root of 4 minus x squared. So here's the y-axis. Here's the x-axis. Here's x. Here's y. And if you don't know what this is automatically, what you can do is you can square both sides. So squaring the left-hand side gives us y squared. Squaring the right-hand side eliminates the square root. Then you can add x squared to both sides, and you see that this is actually a circle centered at the origin of radius 2. So what you see here, y equals the square root of 4 minus x squared, is the top half of a circle, so it's going to look something like this. That means this must be 2, this is negative 2, and this y-coordinate here is also 2. The line y equals 0 is a horizontal line, it's basically on the x-axis. Okay, so let's use this picture to come up with our first order of integration. So the top function here is y equals the square root of 4 minus x squared. And the bottom function is y equals 0. So we have the double integral. And let's do dy dx first. So we have f of xy dy dx. So if we're doing dy dx first, we want the functions of x to be on the inner integral. So think of it as top minus bottom. So this one is up top, the square root of 4 minus x squared. So that is your upper limit of integration. And the bottom function is y equals 0. So you see how the top function goes up top and the bottom function goes in the bottom. That is always the case, okay? So that's super, super key. And then the rest of it's pretty easy because it's just x. You can see from the graph that x varies from negative 2 to 2. This will be negative 2 to 2. And so there is our first order of integration. To find the other order of integration, I'm going to draw the picture again really quickly, just because it's getting a little messy here. So here's the y-axis, here's the x-axis, x and y. Unlike before, we're just looking at the top half of a circle. It looks something like this, and this point here is 2. So let's go back to our equation, which is y equals the square root of 4 minus x squared. Now we want to have the order dx dy, so we have to solve this for x. So we'll square both sides. That gives us y squared equals 4 minus x squared. Add the x squared and subtract the y squared. At the same time, x squared added to the left equals 4 minus y squared. Take the square root of both sides. When you take the square root of a variable squared, you always get a plus or minus. So we have plus or minus the square root of 4 minus y squared. And now we have a function of y, okay? So what we're going to do now is I'm going to point out what this actually is. So over here on the right side of the circle, this is given by the equation x equals the square root of 4 minus y squared. The left side of the circle is minus the square root of 4 minus y squared. And now we're ready to write the answer down. So we have f of xy, and it's dx dy. So this time it's right minus left. So it's right goes up top and the left goes in the bottom. So the rightmost function, the square root of 4 minus y squared, goes up top, and the leftmost function goes on the bottom. And that's always the case. Okay, always the case. And y runs from 0 to 2. And then so there we have our other order of integration. Just as a quick recap, whenever you have functions of x, as we did in our first result, your uppermost function, your top function, goes in your upper limit of integration. And your bottom function, in this case it was y equals 0, goes in the lower limit. When you have functions of y, it's the rightmost function that goes up top and the leftmost function that goes in the bottom. That's really the key. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out other videos as well on Chegg. Good luck.